नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द येट अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ पायलट टॉक्स।
पायलट की बात।
इन दिस एपिसोड वी हैव अ स्पेशल गेस्ट। ही वाज अ टीनेजर हु एस्पायर्ड टू जॉइन सी करियर एंड ही जॉइंड एज अ डायरेक्ट एंट्री कैडेट। लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस कैप्टन आनंद करकरे। He got command of the vessel in 1985 at the age of 27 years. That's quite early, I would say. In these days, people are getting command very late, I would say. So, and we all know that he is the present advisor to Mumbai Port Trust. Let me just share a short brief intro about his vast profile. He is also a fellow member of Narottam Morarji Institute of Shipping. He's done his degree course in economics and commerce from Mumbai University. He was deputed as chief ports officer to Mumbai Maritime Board. In his tenure, he had the opportunity to formulating policy for development of greenfield ports, ro-ro ferries in Greece, concession agreements. He superannuated as deputy conservator of Mumbai Port Trust in 2018. And he's the present advisor to Mumbai Port Trust on the marine related issues, particularly pilot entry training and career progress training. I believe, sir, Captain Anand is a very good friend to you, and we were due to inviting him on this very popular talk show. So what are your thoughts on his vast profile that we have, sir?
Absolutely, Vijay. Thank you very much for this episode of Pilot Ki Baat. And, you know, our journey of Pilot Ki Baat, as it going ahead, with eminent speakers and the people who have vast experience in pilotage, in port operations, and particularly, you know, in pilot training, is going to really benefit our viewers and also the pilots in India. Captain Anand Karkare, apart from his professional, accolades that he has on his shoulder, he's an ardent supporter of AMPA. He has been with AMPA throughout. When AMPA conducted the first webinar ever on pilotage in India, and Anand Karkare was one of the speakers, and he spoke very well on pilot training regime that the present major port form. So apart from that, his knowledge about port pilotage, his passion about marine related issues, he's been a deputy conservator, so he's been a chief port officer of maritime boards. So this kind of profile building doesn't happen in one day. There has been at least 20-25 years of his experience which has gone into this kind of field, which has made a man of man like him, which is the most sought after, because he is the kind of guy who also keeps very low profile. He doesn't want to talk about his accomplishment very high. He also been invested. He's also been involved in many accident investigations, but he seldom talks about it. So simply that he's a man of a lot of ethics and a lot of challenging work that he's done. And why we have called him now? Because he's a special officer on duty or an advisor to Mumbai Port for pilot induction, alternative system of pilotage and things like that. So he's a brain to be tapped for, So thank you very much, and let's welcome him for this show.
Definitely, sir. So let's get Captain Anand Karkare on board. Warm good morning to Captain Karkare, sir. Welcome to our show.
Thank you.
Hi, Captain Karkare.
Hi.
Thank you very much. Thanks for joining. And you are the most sought after person for this show, for a simple reason, that because you had been, associated with AMPA since beginning, number one. And number two, you also have been very ardent supporter of whatever we do differently, and that is, I think, so because of your pilotage heart. So art also and heart also, both. So that's why you are the most sought after on this show. But we have finished so far 15 episodes, and this is the 16th episode we are shooting with you. And it's an immense pleasure for AMPA team to invite an eminent personality like you, who has been there, done that, most operational, hands-on. So I would ask Vijay to go ahead and ask the first question, being aspirant, pilot himself, and also a master mariner who has recently come into the shore job footings. So, he is more than eligible to ask your first question, sir.
Okay.
Vijay.
Sure. Yes, since I have got in touch with Captain Gajanan since January, I was more involved with the marine pilots through him, and it was my privilege to be working with marine pilots. And it's one of the most riskiest job that we as seafarers, we are not aware of. Going through your illustrated career, your bio, I was very much overwhelmed, and I was really keen to know about your passion for pilotage. So if you can just share in short, how did you start your career from being a master mariner to a pilot?
I would say that the Merchant Navy career, what I started with, was way back in 1975. It may be very old for the people, but now I'm already a sea dog, you can say, or the pilot guy. I started my career in 1975. In fact, I would say that it was more of a passion, attraction towards the sea career that I left my engineering halfway. After fifth engineer semester of mechanical, I left and joined Merchant Navy. And it was really so that training was one thing what I would say was the most important factor even in Merchant Navy. I have spent, it was a kind of a record I would say at that time, that I spent my 3 years nonstop on board at one ship as a cadet. So when I joined in 1975, I still remember the date, 9th October 1975 to 7th December 1978. It was on one ship.
Okay.
So when I appeared, we went to the MMD, Captain Prasad was there. He looked at my sea service record. He said, "How's that on one ship?" Only thing, the word he didn't say was, "Are you crazy?" But I knew what he meant about it. So that was my passion. That explains my passion to the. I never got bored because on the ship, it was a kind of a love for the sea. What I came, and even now also the pilotage, I would say, is another one to be in touch with the shipping all along. It is a kind of a bridge between the shore and the sea life, and I would say that the pilotage career is one which keeps you with the. What is happening in the shipping? What are the new developments are there? How the present generation is functioning on board? New aspects of the shipping that pilot comes to know. And what I would say about pilotage service is that there you get your acknowledgement immediately. Like what is called as a job satisfaction. That one thing is in pilotage you come to know. Whether somebody else will tell you or not, it is different. But in your own mind, when you have climbed the ship and when you get down from the ship, you know how you have done the job. A ship coming alongside without any hassle in the least time and with that smile or the relief on the face of a master or the joy of a master, that itself gives you an acknowledgement that yes, you have done a good job. So I would say that pilotage is the one where you don't carry any baggage back home. That is one good aspect of a pilotage career or a shore life. Otherwise, I am sure that when you are working ashore with some company and all the time you have backup in mind that I have to do this, I have to do this, and then how you go ahead with that. Whereas pilotage is, you absolutely divide your time for the, like you in Mumbai port, initially, when I joined, it was a 24 hours on and 24 hours off kind of a work pattern. So 24 hours you were there, you were continuously piloting the ship. And then later on 24 hours, you could devote your time completely to the family. And I would say that it was so and so that it whatever you had lost time with your family, that you made up with by that. So I must, you know, the pilotage career is one good thing. People should think of option. And it is, yes, it's a challenging option because in middle of the night, you have to board the vessel. You have to carry out the entire environment on board the ship is aligned and is absolutely alien to you. Particularly the night, it's something different. In fact, I'll give you a real funny incidents. You can delete it or you can hold it. I was in Mumbai port. There is a gradation of tonnage of pilotage. That means earlier when I joined Merchant Navy in 75. Then after being a cadet to master in one company, Denpo Steamships. After Denpo Steamships goes down, then I joined those days it was called as East China, Mosol Asia. I was with them. And then I came back ashore and took up a job with Mumbai Port. So in 1990, I joined as a pilot. Those days it was a first tonnage for a pilot was 4,000 GRT. By present standard, it is a very small tonnage. But it was, I would say that those days there were Princess and Victoria dock, they were functioning. So in relation to the dock size, entrance of the dock, the ships were big for that size. But that gave you the kind of a feel of the ship, the absolutely ship handling and all was, you know, the initial, what you call the lessons of pilotage, we learned from that. The when the ship is aligning to the berth, keeping the tide close. In fact, the Princess and Victoria dock gates used to open when the tide was at the second or third hour of the tide, and that is the time when you enter the Princess or Victoria dock, the tide is on your broadside. So how to handle the ship like a crab approach? What you say, making that crab approach to the entrance of the dock was another aspect we learned how to take into its consideration the strength of the tide. So that slowly over a period of time, we graduated from 4,000, 6,000, 8, 12, and then full tonnage. That's how we kept in Mumbai Port. I forgot to tell you the incidents. In the middle of the night, we take a pilot launch and go out. Both pilots, me and my another colleague was relaxing. It was not those days when there were no VTS. So you tell the ship that, okay, captain, alter little course to this side, alter course like that. And middle of the night, you're directing the ship. It happened so that I was giving a direction to the ship on VHF. And he was following the exact same directions. And ship came closer, I boarded the ship. The moment I boarded the ship, I was surprised how come the Indians crew on the Greek ship. And then it was a typical STI ship, boiler suits hanging in the alleyways, shoes are outside near the cabins. So I was wondering, there's something wrong here. I went on board the ship and then I asked the captain, which ship am I on? He says, sir, Bhavuti. That ship was in other guy's tonnage. The next ship which was coming was not on my colleague's tonnage. But anyway, I said that ship is going to anchorage. So never mind, you do that and I'll continue doing this. So I said, these were the days of the pilot age when there was no VTS and we had to go by the VHF contact was there. Then I asked the Gobuti captain, how come you were following what my instructions were? He said, no, sir, I've been coming to this port quite regularly, so I know exactly how to alter the port in port area approaches. And that's why I was doing it. I said, but then the Greek guy who was supposed to be ahead of you, he was following you, and I hope that guy is coming all right, because he should not be following instructions, what I've done. So we have graduated from that kind of a thing to nowadays to VTS, where you keep the track of the ship right from the quite far off. So this is another funny incident. So if you want, you can keep it or you want to edit it. But I just say that I will remind you. I mean, tell you about that.
No, so we have that incident thing in the end, one question. So you only answered that question. That's good. That's really good.
Why shouldn't we keep that incident? Such a nice experience there. And like you mentioned that things have changed a lot. So which one you found it more challenging, being sailing as a master marine or your GIS profile as a pilotage, which was more challenging for you?
See, I'll tell you what, because I've been the master about 2 years, 2.5 years I was master before joining as a pilot. Then in 2000, Mumbai Port that time had a scheme that pilot could go back on a voyage leave of about 1 year. So I took the opportunity of joining back. I joined back that time Anglo-Eastern. Of course, initially I had to join as a chief officer. because that time it was a kind of regulation. If you are not selected at CA, in that you have to go one lower rank lower. And I had no hassle of going at a lower rank. But I tell you, when I was six there, the captain over there, he knew that I was a pilot or I'm a pilot in Mumbai port. So he was a little nervous about it. And he said, because like when he used to go for anchoring and all, he used to ask me, am I doing all right? Is this okay? I said, yeah, no problem. Don't worry. It's all right. So anyway, so the question what you asked me was about the which you find more challenging. Yes, there are both cannot be equated as such. That master's job is has to look at the commercial side. And nowadays with this all port state control and all, it's become another issue. So nowadays another one which has become what you call the thing is criminalization of the merchant navy guys. That is one aspect which has become a real worrisome and a tension-filled job for the merchant navy masters. Pilot job, yes, it has its own tension, like when you take a ship, but really you're not in a family, as I said, then you don't know the characteristics of a ship. So the moment you board the vessel, you have to get acclimatized, kind of a thing. But I tell you, I don't know whether it is a quite a lot of people, pilots may vouch for it, but at least I say that I have that kind of feeling. I get it. The moment you see a ship, you know whether this ship is going to behave properly or not. In fact, this is another incident I will give. Is in series of incidents, because being a merchant pilotage career, I was our control station. If you are familiar with the Mumbai port, the pilotage control station is on one corner of the Ballard Pier extension. If you are familiar with them, from there, I had to cast off one ship at BPS. They are just adjacent berth. As I was walking down the towards the ship, I saw that ship's bulbous bow little flat because of some impact somewhere. She must have had a collision. I said, this ship looks little. She had some problem. Looks like I must go and ask captain what he had any problem. But I went on board and I forgot all about it. But at that time only I felt that there is something wrong with this ship. We cast off the vessel, and as we are passing the middle ground island, I gave a hard over to starboard and half ahead, just to come in the main channel. And at that particular time, the ship's generator count off complete blackout on the ship. And the ship was going ahead with the full, with the half of its speed, already picked up. The ape was behind us on our stern. And another guy, pilot, who was to talk after I had cast off, he was there, he was just going to pick up the anchor. And since I had given a hard starboard and towards the main channel, this ship, the rudder had got stuck onto the hard starboard and she continued to swing to the starboard. And I had to let go my starboard anchor, then I had to let go my port anchor. And after that, I just missed that ship by, you can say, the whiskers. No, that way, just about, say, 40 feet or something. So then, so the God is great. So this is it. Then from that on time onwards, I decided I will never give a hard over moment while turning immediately. And because you don't know the ship, how it's going to behave, is there going to cause any problem? So at least let her come gradually to the in the channel and then behave little. So this kind of incidence is teach. But what I say, the coming back to your question, this is what we call the tension, immediate instant tension what you have, that you have to, presence of mind, let go starboard anchor immediately, you have to let go port anchor also. All these decisions kind of thing, you have to make it in a score of a second. Any more delay and then you are in a absolute dire situation. So what I would say that the pilotage and master at sea, you cannot equate them with the thing, the tension-wise or the stress-wise. Ours is a momentum that at that particular time you get over it, or otherwise you have to face for a longer time. Like suppose you have an accident, then you have to explain what has happened. Though people may say that that thing is there, that pilot is not responsible, the pilot is responsible kind of thing. It may not be from the legal point of view, just because the master is there. But to a certain extent, pilot is responsible for the thing. And then he has to face internal departmental inquiry. Why? what has happened. So that is another aspect what you're looking at. So while as you are talking with the interview here, you will come with like as you were asking a question, I will come out with the different kind of experiences. So this one was, you know, the, what has happened, this particular name, even now I know, they remember the name of the ship, Aurora Maru. The name of the ship was Aurora Maru. So
that's really great. And, like you mentioned, you have such an illustrated career and so many experiences. It's already very exciting to hear your so many experiences and encounters. And I'm pretty sure that these two episodes will not be enough. Maybe some other day we'll catch you again on this episode. And Captain Gajanan sir, would you like to take over now?
Yeah. Captain Anand, thank you very much. And you know, the as it goes on, the storytelling and you know, things like that. You know, I was talking to somebody the other day and we thought that, you know, like what are the new aids for learning, you know, education. So one of the aids he mentioned, storytelling. I said, storytelling has been with us since, you know, ages. I mean, the entire, you know, our childhood has gone in learning about the stories of Ramayana, Mahabharata and all that, you know. So storytelling is a great way of learning. And what you told just now, two stories are fantastic. I mean, you know, they can't be paralleled with because they are very personal experiences. And there's something for when you hear the stories, there's something so much to take from them. Very rightly you said, I mean, those were the days of pilotage. Those were the days of ports where there was no system, there was no proper training. There were less mishaps though. And because there were so much of people like, you know, people like you, I must say, you know, where the experience was not the criteria then, but decision-making, something taking the stride, something to solve the problem quickly with. And these are the basically qualities of pilot. You know, I want to ask you a very particular question. When I have had a lot of, you know, interaction with pilots and, you know, when I was pilot myself in 2008 in Malacca state. So when I've seen that kind of a life very closely, I want to ask you something very particularly on the pilotage and pilot's life. Because, you know, the AMPA's, the main motto is safety and security of pilots, but also a subtle motto is to bring dignity back to pilots, you know. I mean, I'm not saying this is not a dignified profession, but today's day and age, you know, the pilots are neglected a lot in port operations. Though they are very important, you know, the cogs in the wheel of entire port economy, port operation, you may call it safety of navigation, national security, name a thing and the pilot is involved in all these acts. Or pilots' acts are involved in protecting us from all the mishaps. What is that, you know, is not keeping pilot in a top glamorous books of the careers in merchant marine as well as into the other port officials?
See, I will tell you what the thing starts right from the beginning is that as such, in particularly in India, we are being coastal and now there are people who are coming from north and internal areas of the India. So at least the people are aware of the merchant navy. But there are very few people are from aware of the merchant navy as such. Like I will tell you from my time, like our Karkare family, like we had about 8-9 of us in merchant navy. That's why I joined with, I had seen them. And because one of my eldest cousins was, he was a, that what is called a first or second batch of Dufferin, and he was a Royal Bengal pilots. So I had seen this one and that's why it created kind of an interest in me. I would say that that was the thing. But whereas not many people, now people look for a merchant navy more as a option of money that is there over there and not as a kind of a profession or kind of a career. I've seen a lot of people with me who have left merchant navy after a few years and they've done their own job as a joining, so taking a job somewhere or creating their own business model. Now, the coming back to your question about glamour or why the people are not aware of marine pilot. First and foremost, the pilot, when I used to tell somebody that I joined Mumbai Port as a pilot, the fellow say that this guy is a merchant navy, he's from the shipping and how can he be the pilot of in a port? And I could understand their basic doubt since when he has started flying. And does Mumbai Port has a plane as a flight or a helicopter? So this is what kind of, you know, that kind of an ignorance or just not aware of the thing. When you say pilot, then people associate you with the airline, because there is a travel, people have mostly traveled by the air, and that's why they know the pilot means that, nothing else, nothing beyond that. So then you have to explain that, yes, pilot is, doesn't mean that. The basic meaning of the pilot is the one who guides, and this is what we do, we guide the ship. And then they have the basic question that if the airport can, any airport, this guy can fly in and out. So why cannot the ship captain be doing that? Then you have to explain them further that, yes, this is not so. The topography is different. The underwater currents are different. And all this blah, blah, blah things are there. So now creating awareness of this one has to be a more from our side. Say, for instance, just now, like I must say that Samgita, the one thing created by AMPA, it was a really good program. It caught a lot of people on, but it was more in towards the merchant navy or the shipping community. It did not percolate down to everywhere. Earlier, I remember when I joined Mumbai Port, that is the time, Economic Times used to give every Friday or Tuesday, there used to be at least one page on ports and shipping. There was one guy, I don't remember his name, but he started doing that, and at least there was some kind of a interest was generated among ports and shipping. Now you tell me who conducts or who covers the shipping or a port for that matter? Nobody. Unless there is kind of an some accident mishap, then that gets attracted onto the, but not as a normal thing in a newspaper. So that is our own thing that we have to create awareness among the general public over the merchant navy or the pilotage or the port aspect of the. Now, the second thing what you're talking of is the pilot's importance within the ports. See, the mostly what happens that I can give my own experience that I used to work for 24 hours on the ship, and I used to be off for 24 hours. So I'm totally cut off from the port functioning as such, port operation. My job had been only from bringing a ship in and taking her out. Only when I go into the managerial level, like a dock master or a harbour master and a deputy conservator, that is the time when I come into the contact with the other officers of the other department. Till then, in fact, for first 4-5 years, I just knew that our chairman was so-and-so, but I had not met him. I had no occasion to meet him. So that was because ours is absolutely in kind of a watertight department functioning, and that is the reason why we are not in the, though we are important aspect. If we don't do it, the ship will not come. That we know. But others do not come to know till and actually something happens. So the awareness is one thing. Second one is that I would say that pilots got to do. Like one thing what I must admire, that in the private ports, like say for instance Adani or the Reliance and all, there the pilots, the merchant, now I would say not pilots, the merchant shipping guys have got involved into the commercial aspect and all. That's why the recognition of shipping community is more so in the private ports than in the public port, because they are partaking that. So in the public port also, in major ports and also, or for that matter in maritime boards and all, our guys got to take the responsibility. You know, they should come forward and take the responsibility of aspects which are not actually, you know, not directly concerned with your pilotage. But in a shipping, like I always tell the people, that merchant navy or the shipping career is such that you have dealt upon each and every aspect of the thing, be it commercial, because as a master you deal with commercial aspect, be it engineering, like suppose something has gone wrong, engineer comes and tells you, or for that matter, you have been as a cadet or somewhere another, you've been going around the engine room, or you know what is happening. So you have overall knowledge. Only thing, application of the knowledge over here in port industry, you should do it, and you should come forward and do it. Say, for instance, firefighting. You have been doing the, nobody can be better than the shipping guy to look after the firefighting section. Yes, in Mumbai port, the firefighting comes under the deputy conservator's department. But how to improve upon it, how to go ahead, how to interact with the merchants. So that particular interpersonal relationship or interdepartmental relationship, that's what, you know, the our shipping guys have to take. We know why we have to come in the, is, I would say, the bridge resource management, the new thing which are coming to the your course. Why that kind of a thing should be necessary? Because people are not interacting with each other. This I can say with authority because I did my, I was from the, as you said, from the first batch of Merchant Navy, or rather second batch of Merchant Navy, and from 2000 was the second batch I've seen. When I joined Anglo-Eastern ship, after coming down from the watch, everybody used to be down in their cabins. Nobody used to be seen in the smoke room because everybody was happy with their mobile and their own music system and all, whereas we were in the interacting with. So that interpersonal relationship or interdepartmental relationship was in better, and that's why we didn't require a bridge resource management. Why we require? Because there is no things. That's what I say. You can quote it or you can edit it, but this is what it is. So same thing, it applies, because what I say, the application of this particular one is one place and other one in our port sector also the same thing. We must, as a, to make feel aware, yes, we are not known, we are not that one. Why we are not known? Because it is our own day doing. That's what I say. So we have to ensure that we should take upon ourselves to advertise ourselves, to put ourselves, and then see the difference. And over a period of years, I do see a difference in the port sector also, that people are taking notice of it. It is not so in the previous day, was there.
Okay. Absolutely, sir. Great. Thank you very much for this answer. And, you know, this is all what, you know, fulfills the our purpose of Pilot Talks, Pilot Ki Baat, the kind of program. Because, you know, when people like you start talking, there's so many subjects you touch upon. I mean, the question could be just leading, you know, into something to, you know, start talking, or a signal to please tell something else, sir. And then you start with so many different aspects of it. I mean, it's really enlightening, because, you know, the young pilots would definitely now learn a lot from these things, these incidences, what you're narrating. And of course, the knowledge about ports in master mariners. I mean, you touched upon a very important area of knowledge about ports in master mariners. Somehow it is not there in the syllabuses of master mariner, or masters don't take interest unless they want to move in port sector. I've been working in port sector for the last 5 years. I know very well that when I joined the port sector, nobody was ready to take me, first of all. It was by chance of joining a company for a coastal shipping, I came into the port sector, and then I realized myself that I didn't know so much about port sector. But this is a very important aspect of it, you know. You also touched upon pilot training and things like that. We will definitely ask you a question during our next episode to you on this pilot training, because pilot training is something Empire is trying to, you know, escalate to the not next level. You touched upon BRM as well. Of course, the BRM is a buzzword today in pilotage training. And definitely we have your opinion, and which is very, very, very correct, because BRM is basically management of resources, and resources will only be created if people talk to each other, if people interact. And that interaction, you have rightly said that it is lacking on board. So I think, you know, it's very apt questions.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for sharing your valuable experiences and insights. And unfortunately, sir, due to the time constraints, we will have to call you back on our show, and we will resume from where we left. So thank you so much, Captain Gajanan, sir. That was great to hear from him, especially his small experiences that he shared. It was very much interesting for me. I'm sure our audience will love hearing him talk, and they would definitely want him to come back on our show again.
Absolutely, Vijay. Thank you very much. And, you know, Anand has been a very great supporter, because he has a lot of experience behind his you know, professional career. So thank you very much, and for your inclusion, I mean, you know, in this show. And I'm sure that viewers would be very happy. Thank you, Vijay. Thanks to you as well. You know, you've been doing this relentlessly, despite your, you know, other activities on social media and everywhere. Your presence has been imminent there. So So thank you very much. Thanks for AMPA to you, because you're also a member of AMPA now. So I'm very much happy to have a person like you in AMPA, who's not only helping AMPA, but also thinking of taking the pilot issues ahead. Thank you so much. Pilots are blessed to have people like you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. And I also plan to wear the AMPA Safety Ambassador badge whenever I go in my future journey as a journey ashore. So definitely, and wherever I find opportunity, I will invite more and more mariners, existing and past seafarers, to be a part of this AMPA. If not through a member, at least as a safety ambassador.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Take care.